Britain will buy 60 more million doses of Pfizer's COVID-19 vaccine in a deal that will more than double the UK supply of the shot to support a booster program later on this year. That booster program is being designed primarily with the new coronavirus variants in mind. Britain now has ordered a total of 100 million doses of Pfizer's vaccine, which is one of the three shots being rolled out in the country. But they say at this point, they don't have extra shots to give away, particularly to COVID-ravaged India.
We don't have any excess doses of vaccine in the UK at the moment. But what we have done is by providing the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine at cost and working with the Serum Institute of India, they are making and producing more doses of vaccine than any other single organisation. Obviously that means that they can provide vaccine to people in India at cost with the investment that we put in here to get that vaccine up and running so fast.
A study in Britain shows that vaccines can cut the transmission of the novel coronavirus in households by up to half. Here's the full story.
A study in England is reporting that the coronavirus vaccines in use there can cut transmission of the disease by up to half. The research from Public Health England focused on households and offers insight into one of the big unknowns of COVID-19 vaccinations, the extent to which they can keep you from passing it on to other people. The study says people who became infected with the coronavirus 3 weeks after receiving one dose of Pfizer or AstraZeneca vaccine were between 38% to 49% less likely to pass it on to people in their home compared to those who were unvaccinated. Mary Ramsey, head of immunisation at PHE, said that while these findings are very encouraging, even if you have been vaccinated, it's really important that you continue to act like you have the virus. The study included over 57,000 contacts from 24,000 households in which there was a confirmed case that had received a vaccination, compared with nearly 1 million contacts of unvaccinated cases.
Mass cremations were again held in the country for those who died from COVID-19. On Wednesday, India reached the grim milestone of 200,000 coronavirus deaths, the fourth country in the world to cross that figure, after the US, Brazil, and Mexico. Graveyard workers there say they are running out of space. In the Indian capital of New Delhi, one death from COVID-19 is reported every 4 minutes. This, as at least 300,000 people in the country have been testing positive each day for the past week. The last 24 hours brought 360,960 new cases, the world's largest single-day total, taking India's total number of infections to nearly 18 million. Elsewhere in the world, over in Brazil, a vaccination center turns away residents who are due to receive a second dose of Sinovac's COVID-19 vaccine. That's after the government cut nearly 30% of the jabs expected to be delivered in the first quarter of this year. The latest calendar released by the health ministry shows only 73 million doses between January and April, down from the roughly 103 million doses reported last month. The government says the reduction was due to the lower than expected volume of active ingredients received. They also noted that some vaccines still lack a permit to be used in the country. This as Brazil is on the verge of registering 400,000 coronavirus deaths this week after over 3,000 new fatalities were reported Wednesday. The death toll in the South American nation is the second highest in the world after the United States.